Hi, I'm Ben Faber, farm advisor in Ventura, Santa Barbara counties. In this video, I'll walk you through the steps to monitor for common root and crown diseases in avocado orchards. To detect these diseases early and manage them before they spread to other trees, it's essential to regularly monitor your orchard for these symptoms. When you're working in the orchard, keep an eye out for trees that appear unhealthy. Look for symptoms on leaves and fruit, as well as the trunk and the surrounding soil. Pay attention to trees that have dropped their leaves prematurely, have thinner canopies, have no new growth, or have branches with leafless tips. Leaves may be small, wilted, pale to yellow, or have dead tips. Fruits may be discolored or rotting, shriveled, or have abnormal patterns such as blotches. Trees that have no mulch at the base, that have weeds growing around the trunk, or appear to be water stressed may also be infected and reflect tree stress. If you see any of these symptoms, you'll need to examine them more closely to determine whether they are caused by a root or crown disease. Do not rush to diagnose a disease based on only one or two symptoms. Examine as many parts of the tree as possible and record any symptoms you see as you go. Okay, so we're looking at cankers in avocados. And the position of where the canker is found is really indicative of what is causing the canker. Remember, cankers are just a symptom of what is a response on the part of the tree. And so in this case, this is a bacterial canker, and the way we identify it is the position in the tree. It's higher up in the tree, and it follows a certain pattern. So this is following one canker in line. So here's one, two, three, and if we go up, here's a fourth one, and even further up, there's another one. So that's diagnostic for bacterial canker. If we're looking at other cankers that are lower down in the trunk, if they're around the soil line, that's a crown rot, and that's often caused by Phytophthora satricula, which is now called Phytophthora mengei. And just that position identifies this is not going to be bacterial canker, this is going to be Phytophthora mengei. Black streak, which is another type of canker, will often show up higher up in the canopies the way bacterial canker does. And then we have another one called Dothiorella canker, which usually shows up higher in the canopy, but occasionally it can be down along around the base of the tree as well. These cankers are showing up at the base of the tree. You know, when I start looking, I think, oh, maybe that is Phytophthora satricula or mengei, but it's got distinct volcanoes or distinct points where it's erupting. Usually Phytophthora crown rot is more diffuse. Black streak or Botryosphaeria cankers are more diffuse. These are quite distinct. So we're gonna cut into these and see what it is. So we'll dig into this. And there's a pocket under there. And if this were bacterial canker, there's usually a little liquid pocket that's there. But I'm not seeing that. Okay, but we'll take some of the sample and I'll open up another canker right here. And we'll send these into the lab. And we'll probably find out whether it's bacterial or Phytophthora satricula. But usually you need a little bit of sample of both the living tissue as well as the dead tissue. Take notes of the color and pattern of the wood beneath the bark, and if possible, take pictures of both the symptoms and the surrounding conditions. Then brush away the soil under the tree and examine the roots. If you cannot find small roots, or if the small roots are black, brittle, or dead, that means the tree is probably infected with Phytophthora. So when we come out to look at an orchard, first you look around, what's the orchard like? Well, the sprinkler is over there. There's been a pile of prunings that you can see right here. That's an indication that they were probably piled up against the trunk, which creates humidity that makes it more likely for certain cankers to show up. So this is a case of Phytophthora citricola, or mengii, it's crown rot. This is a Phytophthora that's associated with water, as are all Phytophthoras just about. Here's the emitter and it's spraying right on the trunk, and this creates the conditions for crown rot, in this case Phytophthora mengii. After examining the unhealthy tree, inspect several nearby trees to determine whether the disease has spread and how far it has spread. Mark the location of symptomatic trees using flagging tape and record their location on a map or GPS device. This way you can easily return to the tree to manage the problem. Don't forget to disinfect your tools before using them in another orchard. For more information, visit the Avocado Pest Management Guidelines on the UCIPM website.